Continuity of functions of a real variable is defined in terms of limits. Continuity of complex functions is defined similarly in terms of a limit. We saw earlier that the limit of a complex function f exists if and only if the limits of both u and v exist, its real and imaginary part. This property of limits is transferred directly to the continuity property, which means that continuity of a complex function just boils down to continuity of its real and imaginary components, as we'll see in this video. So, what's the definition of continuity in the complex case? F of z is continuous at z0 if the limit z to z0 f of z equals f of z0. Same as in the real case where you just replace z by x's. Actually, we have three things here. First of all, it says that fz needs to exist at z0, because otherwise this one is not defined. Second, it says that the limit exists, otherwise the left-hand side is not defined. And thirdly, left and right have to be equal. So we actually have three statements here. Let's do a few examples. First of all, we have f of z equals 1 over z. Domain of z is C, the exception of 0. What about continuity at z0 equals 0? Well, it's not continuous there because f of z doesn't even exist there in this definition. So, this function is not continuous at 0. Second function, f of z equals z over z bar, for z is not equal to 0, and we define, furthermore, f of 0 equals 1. So, first one is true now. F of z0 exists. However, if we try to take the limit of z to 0, we have already seen in an earlier example that the limit does not exist. Going along the x-axis yields 1, but going along the y-axis yields minus 1. So, limit does not exist. So, this function is not continuous. Let me go to the third example. Function z squared minus 1 over z minus 1. Obviously, for z not equal to 1, otherwise we are dividing by 0. And we set f1 to 0. So what happens if we compute the limit for z to, to 1? So this one is okay. Then we compute the limit for z to 1. But you see z squared minus 1 equals z minus 1 over times z plus 1. We can cancel those out because we are in a limit, so z is not equal to 1. So we can eliminate those. And we are left with z plus 1. And we can just take the limit equals 2. So the limit exists. However, the limit is not equal to the function value n1, which was defined to be 0, which means that the third statement does not hold. Now, last example, example 4. Of course, we can easily make this function f of z continuous. Take the same function if we define f of 1 to be 2, because then all three conditions are met. Now, how can you investigate whether a complex function is continuous? Well, if you have f of z to be u plus I times v in a point z0, then f is continuous at z0 if and only if both u and v are continuous at x0, y0. And for u and v, you have seen already a lot of theorems and statements in your real calculus course. This has a very nice consequence, second theorem. It says if f of z is continuous in some closed bounded region R, then you also know that your f of z is bounded in this region R. Well, why is that? Well, if f is continuous, then both u and v are continuous. For u and v continuous on a closed bounded region R, you have a very nice statement, a very nice theorem, which says that then in that case, u and v are bounded. Well, the norm of f of z is the square root of u squared plus v squared, so u and v are bounded, so u squared and v squared are bounded, the sum is bounded, and the square root of the sum is bounded as well. So you know that the norm of fz is bounded, so f of z is bounded as well. So here you see that continuity of a complex function is really, really very similar to continuity of real functions.